welcome back. Judy Elsie joins us to talk about the new animal ordinance here in Vigo County. We have a lot to talk about, so
yes,
I'm gonna just send it over to you.
Well, thank you. First of all, the new ordinance is out, was adopted in January. When we wrote the ordinance, we wrote it, it's only 9 pages long. We wrote it for everybody to be able to read.
Okay.
So you can pick one up from your veterinarians, you can pick one up from the county office. And look through it. It's friendly. It tells you what you need to be doing and what not to be doing. One of the old ideas that I think we need to clarify is that you cannot allow your dog to run loose in the county. It used to be when we moved there 37 years ago, it was mostly agricultural, and now it's not. And so those dogs cannot be running loose. They are considered a nuisance.
Okay.
If your dog runs and is caught 3 times by the officer, it will be automatically altered. If it is not, because we know animals that are not altered tend to wander away from home.
Okay.
That comes and brings us up to the subject of a breeder, which is a little bit of a hot topic right now. The definition for the county is the same as for the city. If you allow your dog or cat to breed intentionally or unintentionally, you are a breeder.
Okay.
That means that if you have a litter of kittens, surprise, you are still a breeder. You still, according to the county, have to have a $50 permit that allows you to be a breeder.
Okay.
And to get that permit, you go to the treasurer's office, you pay your $50, they will give you an application or registration form, and attach to it your receipt. When you complete it, you then call Officer Shaw, and he will deliver to you your permit.
Okay.
But understand that if you have to have a permit, even if you don't plan to have those animals breed. Therefore, it's time to get them altered now.
Got it. Now, for more information, because obviously this is a lot, and people probably have questions, I'm assuming.
Yes.
Who do they need to contact?
They can contact me through Project Hope.
Okay.
And at 243-7179, or come into a Project Hope registration, which is on Thursdays from 11:30 to 2:30 at the Salvation Army building. And I can chat with them and see what we need to do. There, besides Project Hope that helps with spaying and neutering, there are other alternatives too.
Okay.
So if they come in, I can be a resource for them. But they need to consider getting them altered now.
January 1st, a lot went into effect, and I'm sure people just need to ask some questions.
Yes, they do. There's more.
Okay. Project Hope, that number one more time, 812-243-7179. Always great to see you, Judy.
It's nice to see you.
We'll be right
back. Thank you.